Metacognition is the ability or self-awareness to recognize what you know and what you don't know. And that may seem simple, but there's a very big difference between understanding a concept as it is explained to you compared to being able to explain that concept to somebody else. When I first started to teach professional students, they would ask me, "How can I do better on your exam?" And I would say, "Study." And they would say, "I'm studying day and night." And I would say, "Study harder." Or they would say, "I went into the test and I knew the material, but as soon as I sat down in the room, the material vaporized." Well, it didn't vaporize, but I wasn't very good at articulating a strategy that was helpful for them. But I've come to understand the gap between what students consider to be knowing the material and what I really mean when I say study harder. Students learn the material as it appears on the page, in the order that it appears, without really any context. And what they should try to do is pull that material off the page and look at it from all angles, meaning, for instance, with rotococcus pneumonia, thinking back to immunology, how does immunology impact rotococcus? And how does the fact that it's an intracellular organism change your drug choice? And then they need to think about what they've learned within that week. How is rotococcus pneumonia different from other forms of pneumonia? Or how is it similar? And then they need to think forward. Of the information that's on this page, what will be helpful to me when I'm trying to diagnose this disease or making a treatment decision or advising a client for how to prevent the disease in the future? So metacognition is really critical for success in the third and fourth year. That's the tipping point. Because in the first year, there isn't that much material to reach back for, and clinics is a really long ways off. And in the second year, there's a little bit more, but in the third year, you need to reach back to those first 2 years, and you need to think about how you're going to use it in the future. And when you put the material in that context, it's a lot easier to remember for an exam and in the future. In the last 5 minutes of every lecture, I pose a question to the students, asking them to apply the material that they learned today in a clinical way. They respond in an essay format through K-State Online. I then review every student response and compile the results to present to the class during the first 5 minutes of lecture the next day. I share a number of categories of responses. The best response or the correct answer. There's a category I call also good, which means those are not the answers I had in mind when I answered the question, but they are correct answers and they're actually very creative answers. The next category, misconceptions, are incorrect answers, and this gives me an opportunity to help clarify that material for the students and to reflect on the lecture the day before and think about why that material may not have been clear for the students. And the last category I call answer the question that was asked. In this case, students provided a diagnosis rather than a clinical sign, and this gives me a chance to emphasize to the students how important it is to listen carefully to the question and always answer the question that is asked from clinicians, from colleagues, and from clients. This particular exercise in metacognition helps the students see how the material might be used in the clinical setting, and it helps me to understand the material that was not well understood by the students the day before. It gives me a chance to review that material. At the end of the semester, we polled the students about the exercise, and the responses were surprisingly detailed about how this exercise impacted their learning. I like this first response. I would even discuss the questions with classmates later in the day, which I doubt I would have done with the material had we not had the exercise. The second student said, "The exercise is more firmly situated in my long-term memory." This third one said, "I pay more attention during lecture, wondering what Dr. Rush would ask." And this last one is almost the definition of metacognition. It often showed me that even though I think I got it, apparently I was still missing something and had to go back and figure out what I missed. So now, instead of telling students to study harder, I now can tell them to study smarter, and I can actually give them some strategies that will help them make better use of their study time to perform better on exams, and hopefully to remember the information in the future.